Hi everyone, in today's video I am going to be spilling some exciting tea on Wonderworks Studios' new game, Traitor. You guys don't want to miss this at all, so definitely keep on watching because I'm going to spoil some really awesome things and leaks. If you love playing and watching Overlook Bay content, then definitely hit that subscribe button to show your support. I make a lot of Overlook Bay content and I would love to have you part of our donut squad! Alright guys, so all the leaks that I am going to be spilling in today's video is actually all coming from Wonderworks Studios' Twitter page. Now, they posted on Twitter a few weeks ago this tweet that says, "What if we told you we've secretly been working on another game for a while and it's coming out this month?" So this was actually posted a few weeks ago and this game will actually be coming out this month, this December, and I'm really excited because it is something totally different. So if we move on to the next tweet that they made. This tweet kind of just has a bunch of like emojis in it and no text, and it basically has like two swords, a gun, and it's like two swords plus a gun plus 12 question mark equals a game. So I'm kind of curious what this game is going to be about. This tweet actually kind of reminded me of Murder Mystery because in Murder Mystery, the bad guy has like the knife or something and they try to kill everybody, whereas like the good person has the gun or like the sheriff or something. And for 12, I think 12 is just a number of players that they're going to be able to have in this game. There may be one villain or there may be a lot of villains. We shall see. And then of course this is the game, this equals the game, that's why it says equal and then like the little game controller, the little joystick thingy mabobber. So the next tweet that I have here says, "Our new game was inspired by these games. Can you guess what it's about?" So the first game is Trouble in Terrace Town. I've actually never heard of that game. I'm not sure if it's just like a regular Steam game or if it's on like another platform or if it's on Roblox. I'll have to see that later on. But the next game that they have here is Dead by Daylight. Now guys, oh my gosh, if you guys have not played this, it is crazy. So basically, this is a game that you can get on Steam and it's more like horror based. So if you guys have played Flee the Facility before on Roblox, this game is actually like it, where you have to hack like computers, I guess you can say, or like generators. You have to hack like a certain amount of generators in order to unlock the exit and be able to escape. But there is this beast that is chasing you around and they can hang you or like put you in like freeze pods, if that makes sense with you guys. I'm trying to relate this as much as I can to Flee the Facility, but basically the beast can capture you and put you on these little hooks and it's up to your teammates to come and save you. So as you can see, there is correlation between the two games. And then of course the next game that is listed here is called Among Us. So everybody knows what Among Us is. I'm pretty sure you guys already know what this game is. If you don't, then you've probably been living under a rock for like some time now. But basically in Among Us, there are two imposters and you kind of have to figure out who is the imposter so that the rest of the team, like the good guys, can be safe and stuff. So that's pretty much a sum of what Among Us is. And then it says at the bottom, "Tea coming later today." Just by looking at all these three games, you can kind of get a feel of what this game is going to be. Obviously, this is not like a roleplay game like Overlook Bay. This game has a different theme. Of course, it's kind of like horror-based, but I don't think it's going to be like super, super horror like Paranormica or something like that. This is going to be like kind of cutesy, but still have like the same vibe of Overlook Bay, of course, because it is from the same studio, but it's going to have like a different theme. So we're going to be able to see what that is, and I'm really excited because this game sounds like so much fun. I love Dead by Daylight and I love Among Us and I love Flee the Facility, so I'm kind of excited to see what these are going to be about. So the next tweet that I have here is Tea Time. Here's a sneak peek at just one of the three maps that will be launching with our new game. This map is called Orbital Bay. Oh my gosh, how cute is that? Orbital Bay! Like Overlook Bay, that is too cute. I love that. They're so clever with their names. It's an abandoned space station in outer space, built by the super talented holiday pawner, of course. All right, guys, so if we look at the first photo right here, this looks like a photo of like the lobby, like a main lobby. We can see like a bunch of seating area. And then we also have like a little desk in the back where you can like do check-ins. What's the name of that? It's like reception. There you go. It's like the little reception area, and then it has like the grand stairs that leads to like the back door. I can't really see what that says. Actually, let me try it and see if I can zoom in. I don't think I can zoom in, but it looks like it says reactor something. Reactor Bay, I don't know. In that room, there's gonna be like a reactor, so it's kind of like Among Us in a way. So if we look at the next picture, this is kind of the outside of the space station that we see. Down by the door, you can see that it says lobby, so that might actually be the way in. I'm actually not really sure where we're gonna be able to spawn in this game, but you might actually be able to walk inside and out of the space station, because this looks like a little area where you can go outside. And then of course, if you look down to like the bottom right hand corner, there's like another building that you can go into. I don't know exactly what that is. And then of course, there's another staircase behind that that you can go up to the space station as well. So it's like another way to enter the space station. So moving on to the next picture that we have here, this looks like the reactor. Oh my gosh, guys, I'm not really sure what those numbers mean on the bottom. Maybe you have to find like a code or something within the map to input it there in order to make the reactor work. And maybe if we make the reactor work, we can probably escape, like have a higher chance of escaping. So that's kind of what my ideology is behind this picture. And then moving on to the last picture that we have here of the map, this looks like it's another space shuttle, or like a I don't even know. Like, it looks like a really cool spaceship. This looks like the little garage area, or like storage area, where there's like a bunch of boxes, and then there's a computer down there by the chair. And I'm kind of curious what these computers are, because if you notice in the first picture, there was a computer in the lobby, and then there's also a computer here. So maybe we can do something at the computer. Maybe it might be like hacking, like flee the facility. I don't know. And then of course, in the back over there, you can see like the two doors that lead to the offices. So there might be other things that we can do within the map in order to increase our chances of escaping. So that's kind of what my ideology or like gist of what I'm getting from these pictures. Of course, I might not be 100% right, but that's kind of what I am getting with those pictures. Also with that tweet, Wonderwork Studios also mentioned that we also wanted to mention a few things. This game will not replace Overlook Bay. We're a studio and we expect to make many new games over the next year or two, and we are going to support all of our games always with fun new exciting updates no matter how many games we have. So far we know that Wonderwork Studios is going to have two games, so Overlook Bay and then also Traitor. So if you guys didn't know, Traitor is the name of the game. Okay, so moving on to another tweet that I forgot to share earlier with like the other tweets. This one says, also, just a reminder, the team working on this new game is different than the team working on Overlook Bay. We're still working on Overlook Bay every single day to make it bigger and better. We have a huge update coming by the end of the year that will solve many issues. Okay, so as you guys got from that tweet, there's two like development teams, I think. Of course, Holiday Pawner built Overlook Bay and like the North Pole map with the help of a few other developers, but what I'm getting from this tweet is I think that Overlook Bay has like two separate teams. So like there's one team for Overlook Bay that is constantly working on Overlook Bay to improve that game. And then of course Traitor, I feel like Traitor is going to have their own team so that each game has their like updates that come out regularly. So like for example, Overlook Bay has like weekly updates. Maybe we'll see like weekly updates with Traitor as well. And since there's two teams, there won't be a lot of stress on, you know, trying to get like the updates out, like information and stuff, because there's two teams, you know, working on each game. So that's kind of what I'm getting from these tweets as well. All right, guys, so that is the end of this video. That is all the leaks and updates and tweets that I have to share with you guys for now. They recently just posted the picture for Traitor. I'm not sure if that's actually going to be the thumbnail. I feel like there's a high percentage of that picture being the thumbnail of that game, but we shall see. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate and love every single one of you. Make sure to hit that subscribe button because we are getting closer to our goal of 6K. We just recently reached 5K, which I'm so blessed and so happy. Thank you guys so much for all of your support, and I will see you guys in my next video.